now to the Aussie who was a producer on the worldwide hits Grease and Saturday Night Fever. Plus, he managed the Bee Gees. Robert Stigwood was one of the most successful and influential Australians involved in the entertainment industry for the screen and the stage. He has a new biography that's just been released, charting Robert Stigwood's life, and Angela Bishop caught up with the author.
In the 60s and 70s, the British music industry was dominated by the likes of Rod Stewart, Cream, the Bee Gees. And the lights all went down in Massachusetts. And guiding these artists to greatness was a South Australian named Robert Stigwood. After moving to the UK as a 21-year-old, the man known as Stiggy was instrumental in promoting the careers of some of the biggest names in pop history.
What came through very early on in his career was he had great vision, and he demonstrated this time and again with his various artists. The Bee Gees, for example, their first number in the UK was not a big hit, and he spent £50,000 of his own money when you could buy a house for £5,000 in the UK. In the first 12 months promoting the Bee Gees. I
started a joke. Author Stephen Dando Collins has just written Mr. Showbiz, the first ever biography of Robert Stigwood.
So what does the average Australian know about Robert Stigwood?
They would know a lot more about his acts, as I mentioned, you know, the Bee Gees, Tim Rice and Andrew Lloyd Webber. He was their manager and he produced Jesus Christ Superstar and Evita and many of their productions. So they would know a lot more about the artists, I'm sure.
As a manager and record label owner, Stigwood's roster of artists was long and impressive.
Fleetwood Mac, Rod Stewart, Andrew Lloyd Webber, Tim Rice, John Travolta.
It was Stigwood who's credited with taking John Travolta from the small to the big screen.
John Travolta, he went for an audition for Jesus Christ Superstar on Broadway. He was only a teenager at the time. And Stigwood was sitting there in the stalls and he wrote on a legal pad, "This kid will be a star one day."
Stigwood signed Travolta to a three-movie, $1 million deal and then cast him in his new disco dance film. Saturday Night Fever became a global smash hit. Film critic Gene Siskel remarked that Travolta looked like a peacock on amphetamines in that famous dance floor scene.
Once Travolta became a big star on Welcome Back, Kotter, Stigwood signed John Travolta to a three-movie deal, and Travolta at that stage was only a TV star. And all the authorities at the time said, "Nah, Stigwood's fouled up this time. He's going to fall in a heap. You can't take someone from TV and turn them into a movie star." Of course, Stigwood did.
But Travolta's success was tinged with sadness when, mid-production, his girlfriend Diana Hyland died in his arms from cancer. To help his young star cope with her death, Stigwood cast Travolta's mother Helen and sister Anne in minor roles so they could lend him support for the remainder of the shoot. Saturday Night Fever was groundbreaking. It also revived the flagging fortunes of the Bee Gees, recasting the trio as disco artists. The soundtrack sold 22 million copies and gave the Gibb brothers their first platinum album. Stigwood also had the Midas touch when he combined the talents of Eric Clapton, Jack Bruce and Ginger Baker.
I love the band Cream, one of the first ever supergroups. Robert was behind that.
Stigwood could see the potential even when they couldn't see themselves, and so they came up with the name Cream because they wanted to be the cream of the crop.
Cream produced the world's first platinum-selling double album, but tensions within the band led to a quick breakup.
The boys did not get on well at all, and Clapton would ring Stigwood and say, "I can't take any more, Robert, bring me home, bring me home." And Stigwood would say, "One more week, Eric, one more week." And then Ginger Baker would ring up and say, "I'm going to murder the bastard." And And then Jack Bruce would ring up and say, please, Robert, please, I'm going to have a nervous breakdown. And each time he'd say, one more week, boys, one more week. And he kept them on the road and propelled them to success.
As a stage impresario, Stigwood was involved with such seminal 70s productions as Evita, Jesus Christ Superstar, Tommy and Hair.
To get Hair staged in the UK, he had to get the law changed. Up to that stage, every theatre that was going to stage a new production had to send the script to the government to be approved. Censorship of the worst kind. And, of course, anything with a titillating scene or a naughty word in was immediately crossed out with a
blue pencil. Full frontal nudity from the entire cast.
Exactly. And he put all the cast on a retainer for months while he'd booked the theatre, so he's paying for the theatre. He knew and was determined that he was going to win, and he did. And the law was changed, so Stigwood changed the censorship laws in Britain to get Hair staged.
He'd enjoyed the highs, but the 80s was a dark decade for Robert Stigwood.
The Bee Gees, Clapton and Lloyd Webber and Tim Rice, all within a matter of months, decided to leave him. And the Bee Gees sued him for $120 million.
The Bee Gees claimed Stigwood had held back on their royalties.
He countersued the Bee Gees and they settled out of court and made up again. So much so that in 1997, when the Bee Gees were offered a Brit Award for Best Achievement, they said, we'll only accept it if Robert is included.
And Robert, as the greatest showman in the world, if you don't accept this award alongside us tonight, then we will not accept it either. We love you. Thank you.
I am deeply honoured to share this award with the greatest songwriters and performing artists in the world. I only
want to say... Robert Stigwood died in London last year, and Andrew Lloyd Webber led the tributes, calling him the great showman who taught me so much.
Stigwood created what I would say is the soundtrack to my life.
His life would make quite a good movie.
Oh, absolutely. And my agent in New York has had approaches for both a documentary and a TV miniseries. And I'd love to see that.
Beautiful.
Oh, wow. The other thing I love about him too is particularly in those last shots, what an Aussie face.
Yeah,
that's an Aussie guy who's done all right.
Yeah, that's true.
And the last of a great tradition of entrepreneurs.
Yeah.
A phrase you don't hear anymore, show folk.
Yeah.
And the music of the Bee Gees.
I mean, we're just talking about the musical.
The best music. Mm, yeah.